Okay, Bill, getting started on your Super 998.
We'll be right back.
Okay, got the switch box all buttoned up, all wired up. I had to take the front of it apart again because I noticed the channel numbers were ghosting. And what I mean by that is that this number over here, the 8, would show up very faintly in the number 1 digit position, which means that there was a short on the little panel board that I put in there. And sure enough, you know, I had to take the whole thing back apart again. I don't know if you were able to see me put that together, but so it was a pain in the butt. So I had to take it back apart and completely redo it, make another one, use another PC board and put it back in there, but it's not ghosting anymore. Okay. All right, this switch right here, I got it mislabeled. All right, down is channel and up is band. I apologize for that. I'm not going to hold your radio up for it. I requested another one from my decal maker, and if you want me to, I'll send it to you. It won't be here before I'm through with the radio. I got to put the amp section back on there, and then it's ready to ship. All right. Okay. Just wanted to show you where I'm at here. Okay. We got the amp just sitting on there. I haven't fastened it down yet. That band's pretty quiet. Hell. Test 1 2 1 2 test. Audio hello test. Probably gonna need to turn that down some. Audio. Backing up. So I need to turn my power down. Test 1 2. Audio. Still backing up. Audio. There we go. Audio. What's that? That's about 800 watts right there. Let's switch to sideband. Hello, audio. Audio 1 2 1 2. Audio. That's 400 watts RMS. Audio. 800 watts peak. So, and let's see. Okay. Set this on 385. Test 1 2 1 2 test. Audio hello. Far so good. Let's put this on power. Where's the meter? Audio. That looks good. Modulation lights working. Okay. And it's time to start closing it up. Now I've got the switch. I'll show you this again, but the switch here on the front for the amp, with it up, it's amp and fan. Center position cuts the amp and the fan off.
lower position runs just the fan on. So like if your amp gets really hot and you want to let it cool down, just leave that switch in the down position. The amp is off and the fan is running. Okay? The center position, both the amp and the fan are off. All right? The switch here in the back is the high cut. I don't know if you can hear that or not. High cut is on, high cut is off. Okay? I'm going to leave it off and you can turn it on if you need, if you want to. All right? Just doing some more checks. I had to do a frequency alignment. Make sure all of that stuff was working correctly. Hello. Audio hello. And voltage up 14.9. Hello. Audio. 1,000 watts. Easy. That was on the AM. What do we got on sideband? Audio. 950. Okay. Now I'm going to turn the fan on and let the fan, well, the amp's not hot, of course, but just checking out all the switches. Let's see. Hello, audio, audio, hello, audio. Checking the frequency. How many amps are we pulling on AM? About 41, not even bad. Of course, I'm not talking into it either. Alright. More to come. Okay, wanted to give you a quick shot of the inside of it before I put it all back together. Of course, there's your Lescom enhancements. That guy there, they both were 1,000s. They're now 3,300s. Did the upgraded filter. You don't have FM, so we put the 15 kilohertz wide filter in there. That's only good for AM. And of course the first RF amp has been upgraded to a 2SC2999, plus the alignment, complete alignment's been done on it. And we also did the frequency alignment. So, all right, more to come. Okay, there it is. Got your Lescom serial number there on the back of it, number 219. God, it's hard to believe I've built 200 and almost 220 of these damn things. People like them. Especially after I juice them up. But let me get some power hooked up to it and we'll do some testing. Okay, I'm gonna have to hurry. My battery's just about dead. This is where we're gonna do the testing. I have a 1,000 watt slug in RMS, 1,000 watt slug in peak. Okay, so we're going to be reading on the bottom scale on both meters. Where it says 100, that's actually 1,000. All right, I'm on AM. I have RF power turned all the way up. Mic gain's all the way up. And you saw what frequency we were on. Hello, audio. Audio 1212. Audio. Hello, audio. Now, when you're on AM, I recommend you run the power about 9 o'clock. Ah, deal. See, don't put that much strain on the amplifier and your peak still goes to 800. Audio, hello, audio. Okay. All right, it's really fussing at me now. Lower sideband. Still on the same channel. Hello, 1-2, 1-2, audio. Audio, hello, hello, audio. Audio, 1-2. This, I'm doing all of this at 13 volts, okay? I'm gonna run it up. There's 14, 9, 15 volts. Still on lower sideband, same channel. Audio. Audio. Okay, now I'm gonna switch back to AM. Hello, audio, audio, hello, audio. Audio, 1-2, 1-2, audio. I still got our AM power turned down to about 9 o'clock. Audio. You see where the meter's going. Okay, let me charge the battery, and I'll come back and show you the functions of the LC6404. Okay. So here's some of the functions. Of course, now this knob set down here, it doesn't do anything. It's a dummy. This is your 10-turn clarifier, which you're going to learn to love. Show you how far up it goes. All right, that's 9 kc's up, okay? Almost another channel up just with the clarifier. Now I'm turning it down. Okay. That's center frequency. Now we're going to go on down. That's 5 down. And there's another 3. Okay. So 9 up and 8 down. That's pretty good. Look at the control you have with this thing. Boy, you'll be able to dial people in just perfectly. Okay, the scan function. You have to set your squelch to where it just quiets. And then, of course, flip the lever up to scan up. Let's see, can you see me? Yeah. Flip the lever up to scan up, and it starts doing this. All right, when it stops on a signal, it'll do that until the signal goes away. Then it goes back to scanning. All right, to stop scan, you can either put this in the center position and listen or open the squelch up to stop it. Now, if it stops on a signal that you don't want to listen to, just click the channel selector in the same direction it was scanning, and it'll go back to scanning again, unless there's something on that other channel. Okay? Down does the same thing, only in the other direction. In other words, if you hear something and you don't catch it in time, you can like go up and look for it, and then flip the thing and go back down and look for it, and go back up and look for it until you find it. Okay? Now, this is your favorite switch. What you want to do is channels that you want to store, select the memory button, you know, which one you want to store it in. Let's say we're going to put the next to the last channel in position 1. Okay. Press this down. You'll see the display disappear. We've just stored that frequency in memory channel 1. Here, let me set this down so that I'm sure that me moving it around is not helping you guys. And I don't have enough room on my workbench. Okay. That's better. All right. So we just stored that one in the first position. Okay. Now we're going to go, let's say, to the Super Bowl channel. Right there. We're going to put that one in channel 2. Again, press that down. We just saved it in memory channel 2, or memory position 2, however how you want to look at it. Now I'm going to go to memory position 3. We're going to find another one. Let's say we want to put emergency channel in 3. All right. Let's go to 4 now. Put channel 19 in 4. And now I'm going to go to 38. We're going to go to the 5th position. Press that down. We're now in 38. Okay. Let's say you're on the lower side of 38. All of a sudden you want to go to your next to lowest frequency. Put that around on 1. Flip the switch up. And this is a momentary switch. There's 14. It'll sit there and blink at you until you turn the lever loose. All right. Now, we want to go to, 19 real quick. Now we're on 19. And now we want to check what's on the Super Bowl channel. Oop. What did I do? Get. Yeah, I messed that up, didn't I? Saved the wrong thing. All right, well, let's go back to position 2 and save the Super Bowl channel. Okay. Did I put that? Yeah. All right, now we're going to go to 38. No, 38. Anyway, you get the general idea. This switch here, put that back around in 1. This switch here. This is your CSF switch, okay? Now, it's actually labeled incorrectly. With it down like that, your channel selector changes positions, okay? With it up, your channel selector changes bands. 45 channels at a time, which allows you to go from the bottom to the top in record time. Okay. And of course, this is your amp switch. Up, the amp and the fan is on. Uh-oh. Got something in the fan. That piece of cardboard. Which is the details for the fan, and I'll put that in there. Let's see, did I get everything out of the camera? Not quite. Okay. With it down, it changes channels. All right. Let's see. Your high cut switch is on the back. Let's put this where it'll make some noise. Just reach around over the top. Flip it up. High cut's on. Down, high cut's off. And it's labeled back there. Okay. On this side is where the fan plugs in. Let's see. Can you see that? Nope. Can't see that. Okay. High cut switch is over here. Just reach over the top. Flip that up. High cut's on. Down. High cut's off. On this side over here is where the fan plugs in. Okay. There's a little power jack there on the back. The fan plugs into it. Okay. Let's see. I know what else we want to do. We want to go to the top. That is your highest frequency right there. Come on, show me the picture. That's your highest frequency. All right, right on the top edge. Well, not on the top edge, but in the high part of the 10 meter band. Okay. One click over and that's your lowest channel, your lowest frequency. Okay. Put that on AM. Put this guy here. Let's see, where do we save 19? I think it was 4. Nope, that's 38. Nope. Okay. Yep, there's 14. Let's do 6. And put 19 in. Oh, you got to change this every time too. That's probably what I didn't do. Okay. Get, we're at the high frequency. Get, we're on 19. Okay. All right. Wow. I think I'm finally finished with this damn thing. Took me a while. And now you guys see why it takes me so long to do these things, because of all the stuff that I gotta do. Okay. It takes a long time to do one of these. Because, you know, I have to take it completely apart to do it. All right. Now, I'll get her boxed up and shipped out to you. And I thought that you had ordered an SP1A, but you didn't. But you got the CP1, and that's been installed. Okay. Bill, I sure hope you enjoy your new radio. It was my pleasure to build it for you. 7-3, everybody.